I'm just like a facilitator. I'm just translating my experience, what I've been doing in IoT transformation, and how 5G can actually enable to overcome those challenges. Okay, so there are quite a number of slides. I don't want a one-way traffic, definitely. It should be more, it's a tutorial, so it's like a learning curve for both of us. So my name is Anand. I'm a BITS Pilani graduate and IIPM MBA. I have close to 20 years of experience, and I've been on my own for the last 15 months with my Anasup Consulting. Prior to that, I was heading the technology platform engineering for Verizon Communications, which cuts across wireless, wireline, enterprise, and the new generation business, Yahoo also. So I was a transformation leader, done something like DevSecOps, migrated 5,000, 6,000 applications into cloud, and also in the wireless part where we have done SDN, NFV, and finally 5G. So before I start, how many of you feel like, is there a 5G smartphone in the market? So can anyone answer? In today's market, as of today, is there any 5G smartphone in the market? So you're all coming from IoT world, right? Do you guys don't follow Mobile World Congress, Barcelona? So it's announced. So 5G smartphones, clap, let's clap. You have a beautiful foldable 5G smartphone that's in the Barcelona. And can somebody tell me which are the companies that they have launched? At least two top companies? One person at a time. So I have some chocolates also. I can give you just, Samsung? Huawei? Okay. Oh, okay. So everybody is a transformation specialist. Everybody is into IT. What do you feel like how 5G can actually transform the whole world? Next 3 years, 5 years, there's so much of 5G talk. Be it editorial, be it geo communications, be it Indian, mobile associations. There's so much communication. So can someone tell me like why 5G is required currently? Just couple of layman language terms. Why you feel like today's modern world, you need like technology like 5G. It's not new. It's 4G is there. But why so much of, I'm not sure of a hype cycle for 5G. But then why do you need a 5G? We all use mobile handsets day in, day out. Why do you need a 5G? What is so different about 5G? Just common one. Just say. Higher speed, yeah. Anything else? Right? What is the new oil? Data. Do you think the current speeds can actually enable personal assistance tomorrow? Do you think drones, autonomous vehicles, quantum computing, blockchains of the world will run on the current technology? The infrastructure is not, you need high speed, high bandwidth. And so there are a lot of changes that's happening. And in technologically, can someone tell me what is the difference between a 4G and a 5G? What is so difference in networks? Or how virtualization is enabling 5G? Can someone tell me what is the major shift that's happened between 4G and 5G? Or in the communication protocols? Yeah, cloud wrap, definitely. One word which is cutting across IT, communications, automobile. There's one word which is like, even EFI has that conference. It's a very open world. It's open source. So the major transformation between 4G and 5G is you have routers which is open source, you have protocols which is open source, and it is vendor agnostic protocols. So all that will sit on a hardware software integration on a layer where they will just be virtualized being sitting on the world, moving from a traditional model of old stock school of data centers to probably a new center of virtualization where even computing like edge computing, fog computing, all the computing which you see can actually help 5G. Okay. So before I start, what is your expectation next 1 hour, 20 minutes? It's going to be a dialogue. So what is your expectation? Something that you have signed up, you come here, you're going to spend some time for more than 90 minutes with us. So what's your expectation out of the tutorial? Some expectation, So this is how I have actually, this is just the learning curve. I've already bugged you down with IoT introduction, so everybody knows, but then I don't because it's IoT, so I have to start with IoT. Standards and regulation, again, but boring, but I will see like some cartoons, some gimmicks are there, so that you don't get the feeling. Please stop me. I'm not here to just keep giving slides. Just stop me, we can have a dialogue. Share your experiences, platforms. Maybe you can even come down, just share your thoughts. It's feel free to, you know, it's like a tutorial. It's not like a classroom. Third, I'm little connectivity of 3GPP, which I feel like it's more of how G protocols can actually enable 5G. Fourth one, I'm a fan of data protection. So I'm a data protection officer myself, GDPR certified. So I would like to talk how 5G can enable data and what all platforms and privacy can actually go, because there's a whole lot of story that's around for privacy, be it your individual actor, be it your personal information. So I would like to emphasize a bit on that. And finally, I have some key takeaways on this. Why markets are performing, for how as an entrepreneur or a person who gets engaged to IoT can take up 5G as well. And finally, I have to run through some use cases which everybody knows, but just a closing thought. So some key takeaways that I have kind of, it's exactly completely non, it's not a full technology protocol. It's something learning about 5G, then some use case discussion. Of course, this is where you can participate. And finally, some of the trends that's happening in the connected world. Okay. So this is a session one. I just want to debug the IoT and some of the IoT challenges, recommendations, and business case of IoT and IoT applications. Before I just jump on to the debugging the IoT, so last 8 hours or 9 hours, you guys have been here, right? So what did you feel like, you know, some good about IoT in this IoT show from the morning, be it your stalls, be it your interactions with various guys? So how do you personally groom in last 8 hours? Something like in the IoT, you know, some one or two people can just come over. What did you learn that you have studied theoretically or listened to in BBC or some channels or, you know, some classes, office, something that you have been here practically only exclusively focusing on IoT? So just what is your debugging? What's your thought? Okay. Okay. So any learning that you got promising, why you feel like promising? Is it because of money? Or is it because of that you want to change your career? Okay. Great. Everything is everywhere. Be it information systems, be it sensors, be it controls, the whole gamut of things. So what is IoT? Just a definition. I don't want to read through. It's just basically anything that you get physically connected through software, hardware. You have devices, electronics, software, buildings, cars, everything that enables between connectedness. So can someone tell me what is the number of devices that will get connected by 2021, 2022? Any numbers? Sorry? Okay. Okay. So what is the data? What is the proof of your data? What is the source of your data? Okay. Okay, somewhere on 20 billion in 2022. And in 2020, it's something like 10 billion or 7.5 billion. There are some market reports which is like giving 3 to 4 angles. But I have understood somewhere on 20 billion devices. So this is the same name. We had mission to mission. You had Internet of Things. You had World Size Web. And you have Skynet. So all of them are what we call it as. Different names, but same concept. It is existing. It is not that it is not existing. It's just a new name. It's the same name, but in a different angle.